Mechanical Pros, and today we're going to take our display model mini split and we're going to make it an operating mini split. We've got 3/4 ton mini split head, Daikin mini split head, 3/4 ton condenser. We built this little stand for display, but we're going to go ahead and pipe it up, power it, show you how to make it run. So I'm going to move this. So first thing, when you're unpackaging this mini split head, it's going to have this back plate on it that we've already mounted. You'll just pop it out of the two inserts right here. And then you can set this off to the side and you go ahead and mount this on your wall. It's got screw labels where they go in your studs. So you're going to mount this. Usually it's about 8 foot up, depending on your ceiling height. Make sure you just look in the book, read the manual before you go and start piping it up. On this already, we've cut a hole for our piping in our stand so we can run it behind it. So we'd mount this, and then the next step would be taking the mini split head apart, taking the decorative cover off so that we can get to the working internal parts to pipe this up. So when you're working alone, you're going to have to hold this mini split up in the air and pipe it at the same time. They make some handy brackets. I'm going to use that to hold the mini split up while I'm working on it. And they just hook in where the bottom of the mini split would hook in. All right, we're going to pull filter panel off and then we'll pull the decorative cover off. So this just opens up. There's two tabs you pull out on each side. And that comes out of the way. And then you have two screws in the white panel that have to come out. I'm going to pull the air directional louver off so I don't bust it up trying to get the decorative panel off. And there's your decorative panel. So you can see the piping in the back is what we need to get to. All right, so the piping on your mini split cassette head. So here's your gas and liquid line and your drain. Now these can come out multiple different ways. You can come out the bottom of your mini split and there's just a tab that you gotta take off the decorative panel. You can come out the side. You can go through a wall like this, or you may be penetrating an exterior wall. Well, you'll just drill a hole right here and go straight out. So they'll just rotate the way you need them to, all right? But since we're gonna go through this panel back here, I'm just gonna put them through here like I'm going through a stud wall. So our piping's in our wall, right? So this is what we need to connect to. We've got our pipe like it's going through a stud wall that's not drywalled, so I can still see it in the back. And this is what we're going to connect our line set to that's going to go down to our condenser. So I'm going to take these caps off and I'm going to save them. These are the caps I'm going to use on the line set instead of the ones that came with the line set. All right, so we mounted the indoor unit. We're getting ready to run our line set on that. Now we got to mount our outdoor unit. So our condenser, it can sit up off the ground either on a pad like we have here. Just a preformed pad, you just want to make it sit level. If you're up the northern climates where you're going to get more snow, a lot of people will mount these on the wall. They make a wall bracket for it. And you get it about 3.5-4 feet up, depending on your snow line. If this is mounted over a walkway, they make a drain line for it. You just attach the drain to the bottom and you can run a drain line out so that when this thing goes into defrost, you don't have a bunch of water dripping on people. But for us, we're just going to mount this right onto our pre-made stand, and then we can start running the line set. All right, so it's mounted where it's going to be. We're gonna go ahead and take the cover off so that we can start making the line set. So when you're running the line set, you wanna make sure you look in the book. There's a minimum maximum length. For us, we gotta look at the minimum length, so since we're so close together. Typically it's 10 feet and it'll give you a maximum distance you can run. So if you run into that maximum, you know, you gotta figure out how you're gonna move that condenser closer to the unit. So we'll go ahead and get the line set and get that started. All right, so you can buy a line set with the SJ cable already attached to it. This is the SJ cable. It's got 4 wires in here, 2 for power, 1 for communication, and 1 for ground. That'll talk between the indoor unit and the outdoor unit. So you're only gonna be powering the outdoor unit with your disconnect that your electrician will have to run for you. So we're gonna go with the minimum feet and roll out about 10 feet of this. We got 10 feet rolled out. We're gonna cut off the excess and then we'll start reflaring this to hook both these indoor and outdoor units up. So we've got our indoor unit mounted, our outdoor unit set in place. Next thing we're gonna do is hook the copper up. So on the indoor unit, you can see you've got your flare fittings with your backup nut already on the copper. What you wanna use is two wrenches so you don't twist these off. I've already loosened them, so I'm just gonna take the flare nuts off. Take the little safety copper out. Pull the safety out. That just keeps it from getting any moisture or anything like that in there. And then I'm gonna use these nuts instead of the nuts that came on the line set to reflare my copper. So we'll go over how to do that. I've already cut the copper to the length I want and deburred it. Next step, I'm gonna put the flare nut on. I'm gonna take my flaring tool, set it to the right size. We're using 3/8 copper. It's got a stop on it. So you should push your copper until it hits the stop. Slide that out of the way. This will come up, tighten down on it. And then this is a clutch type flare tool, so it won't let you over flare it. It'll stop before then. And you can see the flare we've made. So once you've made your flare and it looks good to you, make sure you have one of these R410A flare size guys charts, because you want to check that your flare fits in here without going through it. So our flares are made, our line sets ran up to the indoor unit. We're going to go ahead and show you how to hook up the indoor unit line set. So when you look in the book, it's going to show you that right on the end of your flare, you're going to put some POE oil, and then you're just going to mate it up, run your nut on, and just get it finger tight. Once you get it finger tight, there's a torque spec we're gonna go through. The 1/4-inch nut is 13.3 foot-pounds, and the 3/8 is 31 foot-pounds. So we've got our torque wrench already set for 13.3 foot-pounds, so we'll do the small line first. So you need to put a backup wrench on the backup nut. And you're gonna tighten down until it beeps. All right, so we'll set to the 3/8 nuts, which was 31 foot-pounds. We're gonna put a backup wrench on the backup nut. We're gonna set our torque wrench to the right size, and we're gonna tighten that down until it beeps and tells us that we're at 31 foot-pounds. And you're tight. And then we'll move on to the condensing unit. All right, so our line set's hooked up. Everything's good to go on that, torque down. Now we're gonna start wiring the unit. I'm gonna go ahead and start at the condenser. So I'll go down, remove the cover, and show you where to land these. So we're gonna have to remove this silver cover first. That's gonna give us the access to land our wires. And then we're gonna remove this cover because this is the path we're gonna take to get our wires up to the unit. This is also where the electrician will put the 208 or 230 power voltage through. We've got our SJ cable that came with our line set. We're just gonna run that through here. This little connector to keep it safe. And it's got to run up and it's got to come through this path. So I'm just going to figure out about how much I want to cut off and how far I want to come back with it. Cut the wire and I'll get the wire prepped to install it. All right, so you got your wires exposed. You have four wires in your SJ cable. You're typically gonna find red, white, and black with a green. Your 1, 2, and 3 are going up to your mini, well, 1, 2, 3 and ground will go up to the mini split, but two of them are for power and one's for communicating. So you have to make sure that you land the same numbers on your condensing unit as you do on your indoor unit. I like to make it easy, red, white, and blue, so I just do red, white, and black. As long as I always do red, white, and black, I know that's how I hook the bottom up, and I know that's how I hook the top up, and I'm not worried about frying the boards on the unit. So those are ready. I'm gonna loosen my screws on 1, 2, 3 and ground. And I'm gonna land my wires red, white, and black. All right, so we're gonna continue to hook the wires up. So we've wired the outdoor unit, now we're gonna come in and wire the indoor unit. So we're gonna pop this cover off. One thing to note, on the condensing unit, it started left to right, 1, 2, 3, space, ground. On the indoor unit, it starts right to left, 1, 2, 3, ground. So if you're not paying attention, you hook your wires up the same you did left to right, they're gonna be backwards, you're gonna fry your board. So we're just gonna still make sure one is red. Land it. So the indoor unit's wired. We're gonna go ahead and put it all back together because we're done with this part. We'll put the beauty cover back on. We'll put the filter cover back on and we'll put the louver back in and then we'll move to the next step. We're putting it on. There's clips on the top that it'll pop back into, and then same on the bottom. And then we'll put our two screws in. Now I'll gently put our louver in. So now we're ready to remove our Mighty brackets. So we got the cover back on, filter door back on, I got the louver in. Now last thing, we got the Mighty brackets out of the way, is snap it into the back. You'll feel for your clips, push that in, and your indoor unit's secure. And next we'll go over the drain, hooking that up, and pressure test and vacuum, we can get this thing started up. All right, so we've pulled our vacuum, passed our degradation test. Now we unhooked the gauges, we're ready to release the charge, and we can go power this thing up. So first thing we're gonna do, take these caps off. Just get them cracked loose. All right. We need a 4mm Allen wrench. And you can hear the charge being released. So you screw this all the way out. Put our caps back on. Just snug them down just a little bit. All right, we can put this cover back on and we'll be ready for power. We can go plug it in and start it up. All right, we're ready to go start it up. So we've wired the unit, we've piped the unit, we've pulled our vacuum, we've released the refrigerant, we have power to it. So now all we need to do is test the unit out. So we'll go ahead and just test it and heat and cool, and then it's ready to go. So you'll need the remote, you'll put batteries in it. This will be mounted wherever you want. Take it out, set it to the mode you want, set and cool, and just turn it on. We're gonna turn our temp down and let it run. So we'll let it run and cool, make sure that it's putting out nice cool air. We'll run it in heat, make sure the heat works, and that's it. All right, so that's a wrap on installing a mini split. We went over picking its location, getting it set, piping it, wiring it, condensate, and starting it up. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments. Hey.